Hello friends, welcome to Unix programming tutorials. In this class we are going to discuss about chmod command for changing the permissions of a file. The chmod command, that means change mode, is used to change the permissions of the file after its creation. So that means I created a file, for example I create a file, file1. Okay, so when I create the file, the default permissions is rw-rw-r-. So that means, so first three belongs to user, next three belongs to group, next three belongs to others. So these are the default permissions for any file if you create an Unix operating system. Now, so how I can change these permissions? Now, I want to assign execute permission to user. I want to deny write permission to the group members. So how we can we discuss? Okay. So only the owner or super user can change the permission. Only the owner or super user have the privileges to change these permissions by using chmod command. So now we can see how we can change the permissions. The syntax is chmod. So this is the command. So after that, assignment expressions. After that, you give file name. So assignment expressions includes category of the users. So how many categories? U, G, O. So U means user, G means group, O means other, all are small letters, U, G, O are the small letters. And granting or denial of the permission. So granting is nothing but plus, you are giving the permission to read, you are giving permission to write, you are giving permission to execute. Denial means minus. That means you can deny the execution permission for user. So then we can deny, we can use minus. And how I can assign the permission to the user or owner or all by using equals to symbol. How I can assign the permission to a user or group or other members means by using equals to symbol. So that means next, type of permissions. Type, if I want to grant R means granting the read permission. So W means write permission. X means execute permission. So these three are small letters. Okay, so now you can see, so category of the user. So category of user, U, G, O. U represents user, G represents group, O represents other. So granting or denial of the permission. So plus, minus, equals to. Granting means plus, denial means minus, equals to means assign the permission. Next, type of the permission. So read means R, write means W, execute means X. So now we see the examples. For example, I create a file, the file name is file1. So what is the default permissions? R, W, hyphen for user, R, W, hyphen for group, R, hyphen, hyphen for others. These are the permissions allocated defaultly. I want to grant the execution permission for user. How? So chmod, for which user I am going to permit the execution? User. So write U. I want to grant, so you can write plus. So what is the type of the permission? Execute. So X, that's it. And after that you write the file name. What is the file name? File1. So chmod U plus X, that means for user you are granting execution permission, and the file name is file1. Now this changed as a rwx rw-r-. So this is the current permission of file1. Now I want to grant write permission to all the users. Either you belongs to user, or you belongs to others, or you belongs to a group member. For all these members I want to provide the write. How? Chmod. So I want to provide to all, that means U, G, O plus W, write permission and file name is file1. That's it. Now it is changed as rwx rw hyphen rw. That's it. Now instead of uo, so user group others, we can use chmod a plus w file1. So both are the same. So a means all, u means user, g means group, o means other, and similarly a means all. For all the users I'm granting writing permission. Okay, so next one, chmod a plus x, that means for all these users I'm going to grant execution permissions. That means it becomes rwx rwx rwx. And chmod a minus x, a minus x means I deny the execution permission for all. Now it becomes rw hyphen rw hyphen rw hyphen. So at a time we can assign permissions to more than one file also. For example, there is another file, file 2. The default permissions is rw hyphen rw hyphen r hyphen hyphen. Now I want to provide execution permission to both the files for all the users, then how I can write? Chmod, I want to grant execution permission for all, so a plus x, what is the file name? File1 file2. So now the chmod a plus x means the rwx rwx rwx, this is the file1. Coming to file2, rwx rwx r hyphen x, these are the permission for file2. So next one, I want to deny the service of execution for user and grant the execution for group and others for file1. How? So chmod the user, I want to deny, so I can use minus, what is the permission? Execution permission, so x comma, so g group wo others, I want to grant, so use plus. So after that, what is the permission type? Execution file1. So that means it changed as a, so these are the now default, now the permissions of file1 is, this is the one, so rw hyphen rwx rwx, that's it. So this is the permissions after executing these instructions. Now I want to assign only the read, so read permission to the file1. So then chmod a equals to r file1, that means now this changes as r hyphen hyphen r hyphen hyphen r hyphen hyphen, that means for all I am assigning the read permissions for file1. So this is the output. To change the permissions we can use octal digits also. So if you are using the octal digit 4, that indicates read only. For example 5, it indicates read and execute. For 6, it indicates read and write. If I use 7, it indicates read, write, execution. So for example, so this is the file 1, the default permissions are rw hyphen rw hyphen r hyphen hyphen. Now I want to grant all the permissions for user, all, and for group I want to grant only read and execute, read and execute. For other users I want to provide read and write, read and write. So how I can change? By using the octal digit means, so user all, that means what is the number? 7. That means for you 7. For group read and execute, read and execute means 5. For others read and write, read and write means 6. So how I can use these octal numbers means by simply chmod. So first I give the user permissions. User permissions are 7. Next I can give group permissions 5. Next I give others permissions 6. That's it. Now I can write file name, file 1. The first number belongs to user, the second number belongs to group members, the third number belongs to others. That's it. Now it changes it rwx for group r hyphen x rw hyphen. So these are the new permissions granted to the file 1. We execute all these commands in our practical session. So now we see, so how we can change the permissions of a file. For example, ls hyphen l file 1. So these are the permissions of file 1, rw hyphen rw hyphen r hyphen hyphen. So these are the default permissions for user and group and others. Now we can change these permissions. Ls change permissions. How we can change the permission? Chmod space, you can give the permissions here. I am to allocate u plus x. That means I can grant execution permission for user, and the file name is file 1, ls hyphen l file 1. Now it is changed to rwx. So previously it is rw hyphen. So now we can grant write permission to all the users. How? Chmod user group others plus x, file name is file 1. Now we can check ls hyphen l file 1. So rw rw x rx. So now we check the permissions of file 1. So these are the permissions, let us assume. Now I want to allocate the write permission to all the users. How? Chmod user group others plus w file 1. Now we can check for all the users, the w is granted write permission. Now I want to allocate execution permission for all the users. How? Install ugo I use a plus x. That's it. If you check rwx rwx rwx, so all the permissions are changed. We are going to check permissions for file 1 and file 2. So these are the permissions. Now I want to assign write permissions to others. How? Chmod others plus w file 1 file 2. Now you can check the permissions were changed, r hyphen to rw. In this way you can assign the permissions to more than one file also. Change mod u hyphen minus w comma group others plus x execution for file 1. If you check ls hyphen l file 1, these are the permissions for user, group and others. And we can see another one, chmod a equals to r file 1. All permissions are assigned as only write. Now we can see, so how we can change the permissions by using octal number. Chmod 7 means read, write, execution. 5 means read and execute. 6 means read and write. That means 7 means user, 5 means group, 6 means others. File name is file 1. Now we can check. Okay,
So in this way, by using the chmod command, we can change the permissions of a file.